In Teardown, there are two types of mods: global mods and content mods. A good example of a global mod is this laser gun. A global mod can be enabled and disabled, and whenever it is enabled, it is active in all of Teardown. So with laser gun enabled, I can start a sandbox level, and the laser gun is here for me to use. I can start a campaign, and the laser gun is here for me to use. A content mod is a mod that has its own experience. It could be a level that someone's built, or a campaign, or a racetrack, or just about anything. But it is something that is started from the mod itself. The built-in heist example is a good example of a content mod. Selecting it here, I can say that we have a play button. And when I press the play button, the content mod is loaded and can be played. I can enable the laser gun again and play the heist example. And now I'm playing the heist example content mod with the laser gun global mod enabled. So let's start with creating a global mod. I right-click here in my local files and select New Global Mod. With this global mod selected, I get a path down here that is clickable. Clicking it brings up a Explorer window with the files of the mod. I will start with going up one level, and with the global mod folder selected, I will rename it. And now when I go back to the game, if I deselect my global mod, it is updated. Emil's example global mod. Let's take a look at the files in the mod. First, we have the info.txt file. In this file, you enter all the information for your mod, and that is the information that will be visible here when the mod is selected. And now, if I deselect the mod and reselect it, we can see that the information has been filled in. An example mod by Resident Emil. It's a global mod and it's a tool. And the description is just a quick example mod. The other file that is automatically created for a global mod is this main.lua file. This is a script file that is automatically run whenever the mod is enabled. I have already prepared a script as a small example. So I will just paste it in here, save, and go back to Teardown. And now, with Emil's example global mod enabled, I go back to the sandbox and start a sandbox level. And now we can see up here that my global mod, which measures the distance traveled in the game, is enabled. Now let's take a look at creating a content mod. I right click and I select New Content Mod. I select the content mod and click the link down here to get the Explorer window with the files for the content mod. I go up one level and I rename the mod folder to Emil's example content mod. We have the same info.txt file here as we had for the global mod. Emil's example content mod. And as you can see, the difference between the global mod and the content mod is that the global mod can be enabled and disabled. The content mod has a couple of other options. It has the play button down here, and it has an edit button. And clicking the edit button brings us into this default scene in the editor. But we will be looking into the editor in future tutorial videos. And if I play it, I get to play that basic template scene. If we take a look at the files for a content mod, we can see that it has the info.txt file that we just discussed. And instead of a main.lua file, it has this main.xml file, which is the file describing the actual scene in the editor. Both global and content mods can also have a preview.jpg file. This file will also be uploaded to Steam Workshop when the mod is published and used as a thumbnail for the mod. Both content and global mods can also have an optional options.lua file that can be used to make settings, etc. for a mod. You can take a look at this built-in speedometer global mod to see how options are used. And to take a look at how other mods has been made, you can make a local copy. Now I have a local copy of the speedometer mod. I can select it, and I can take a look at the files. And that's the basics of Teardown mods and how to create them.